Hello learners, welcome to the NIOS studio. The topic that we are dealing today, the properties which imply over to the solid state. And the very first property that came into our mind is elasticity. What is an actual solid? So a rigid body, which means a hard solid object having a definite shape and size. Its dimension do not change when a force is applied on it, but it undergoes changes in the dimension. First of all, we need to understand that why do we have different types of states of matter? The reason behind the different types of states of matter are the intermolecular forces. Intermolecular forces, the forces which act between the atoms and molecules are responsible for the structure of atom. And the interaction forces between molecules are known as intermolecular forces. Here, we are going to see that the different type of intermolecular forces gives the reference for different types of states of a matter that existed. For example, we are already aware that three types of matter existed, that are gases, liquid, and crystalline solid. The gases are due to the fact that the spacing between the intermolecules are very large. Therefore, they are not having a definite shape and the size. As you can see here, we are having an empty balloon. And if we try to blow it up, the gases will take the shape of this balloon and the size of the balloon changes. For example, let me try to blow it up. Since the shape of a balloon was already established, but when I imply a gas by blowing it inside, it takes the shape of the balloon. When I try to release the head of the balloon, the gases comes out and there will be no existence of gas inside the balloon. So it verifies with the help of a demonstration, they are free to move. But when these gases are cool or compressed, the spacing between the intermolecules decreases and turns to be in the state of liquid. Now, the property of the liquid is that it will be not having a specific shape, but a specific size. Means, in whichever container the liquid gets contained, it will take the shape of the same container. For example, for demonstration, here we are having a container which has been filled with the amount of water and an empty glass is over here. So when we try to fill this glass, here you can see the liquid takes the shape as same as that of this empty glass. The matter occupy a space. Therefore, we can say the intermolecular forces are strong comparative to the gases. By further cooling, the intermolecular spacing, it will get converted into crystalline solid. And the solid are having the least intermolecular spacing, which consists of high amount of density. And the order or arrangement of the particles are essentially in fixed position particles which are kept together, giving you a perfect dimension in terms of its shape and the size. So if we try to compress or try to stretch a very hard rigid body, it will not change in the case of its size or its shape. Now, we want to look over to the properties which imply over to the solid state. And the very first property that came into our mind is elasticity. What is actually elasticity? So, we can define it as the property of the body by virtue of which it tends to regain its original size and shape when applied force is removed. As you can see, first demo is a sponge, which is having a definite size and the shape. As soon as I imply a certain amount of force, its dimension gets converted into something lesser than the previous one. But as soon as the applied forces are removed, it regains its original size and the shape. For the next example of elasticity is a ripple. As we can see, if we try to imply an external force which can change the shape of a ripple but not its size, as soon as the external force is removed, it will try to regain its shape. So this is the property of elasticity which exists in a solid. Now, coming to the next slide, which is the terms related to elasticity. Elasticity is a property which vary from one material to the other. First, we need to see that what is actually a deforming force. A deforming force is one which, when applied, changes the configuration of the body. As already stated before by showing an example of a sponge, a deforming force is when an external force is applied and it changes, really changes the configuration of the body. The next one shows the property of a perfectly elastic body. It is the property of a body which regains its original configuration immediately and completely after removal of deforming force from it. For example, if I apply an external force over to the sponge, as soon as we remove an external force from it, it immediately and completely regains its original configuration. So in this case, this sponge acts as a perfectly elastic body. But this will be not the same case as in for a pencil. For a pencil, if we imply a much higher force, or can say a much higher external force, it will not regain its original configuration. The next property defines the state of a pencil as a body which does not regain its original configuration at all on the removal of deforming force. Therefore, if we say we imply an external force, a high external force, it will break the pencil into two parts. And after the removal of the external force, it will not regain its original configuration at all. Till here, we had learned that what is actually a solid, what is actually an elasticity. We had learned that if after a certain limit of elasticity, the body does not regain its original shape and the size, which define the term of perfectly plastic body. And if it regains, on the other hand, known as perfectly elastic body. That's it for today. Thank you.